This is a true story about six strangers
picked to live in a house, go to school together,
and have their lives ticked.
To find out what happens
when people stop being polite and start getting real.
The Real World Mouth Sack!
This is ridiculous. I don't even know why I'm in Walnut. I was supposed to go to Rio College, to like a university. I was supposed to go to Santa Barbara and have the party time of my life. Now I'm stuck in community college with all these people in the house, and now I'm gonna have to deal with all of them. I'm so much better than all of them. I don't even know why I have to talk to anyone.
Hi everybody, my name is Natasha Correll, and I'm really happy to be here today with The Real World. It's an exciting crew, and it's also something very new for me. I have a 4-year-old son who I really miss, but this is also good for me because I'm trying out new things and learning new stuff. Hanging around with David, well, maybe I could get, you know, some of his confidence, because he's way, way confident about himself. And, I don't know, I hope it works out.
Hey everyone, my name is Joshua, I'm from Mount Sac, and I'm just here in this TV show. I don't know anything about it, but it's a lot of fun, there's a lot of cool people, and I hope there's pizza.
I'm really excited to be here. I've never done Real World before or anything like it, and I'm really excited for what the season brings. And I'm glad we're going to school together, and I'm really excited to, you know, become friends with these people.
Hey, what's going on? I'm Jody. This is my first time on a show like this, and it's really great to be here. I'm meeting a lot of new people, and, you know, the college experience mixed with the real world, it's amazing. I can't really wait to, you know, see what, you know, the season has in store for me and everything. There's a lot of people here, and we're all, you know, kind of mixed with different cultures and everything, so I think it'll be great, but I think it'll be a little bit of conflict.
Hey everyone, my name is Shelby. I just turned 21, so I'm super excited to be here. We'll be partying it up, going out to the clubs with my roommates. It's going to be a blast. Coming into this house, I don't know what to expect. There's six different people with six different personalities, so there's going to be some conflict. But I'm excited to see what's in store.
Really, like, I looked through all of my notes.
I got it.
And the quadratic formula, like, oh, he didn't even cover that in class.
He
just,
didn't.
No. Okay, all he said was, like, take the book home and read it.
Yeah, I didn't understand it.
Is that B supposed to be negative or positive?
I'm pretty sure it's supposed to be negative, right?
I don't know.
I don't know. I couldn't figure it out.
Yeah,
I have no
idea.
This homework's going to take us forever. I know. I spent 10 minutes doing that.
Letty, but I thought we were supposed to start in the final to get Letty.
Well, I did notice that they weren't paying any attention to me, and I do realize that I do have struggles with math, but come on, I had this one, and they just totally ignored me. I think they just think they're better than me, so I'll just find somebody else to hang out with. I don't need to deal with this. I think I'm just going to avoid them from now on.
It's a kind of magic.
Man, you guys, I am so hungry right now. We need to get some food.
And fast.
Hey, guys, let's get some pizza.
Yeah, I'm feeling pizza.
I don't know. Like, I'm down for, like, a
I
burger.
I had pizza yesterday.
Like, yeah. You got it today.
I had pizza yesterday. So many choices. We could get pepperoni. We can get a cheese if you like veggie.
Yeah.
Come on, you guys.
No, like, okay. Leticia and I had to eat leftover yesterday.
Or Korean? Yeah, but do they even order out? We can just call and get a pizza real quick.
I still don't want pizza.
Well, we're going to have to make a compromise because we don't all want the same thing. So, what if we get pizza tonight and then tomorrow we can go get Korean? Okay.
Sounds good.
Alright. When it comes to food in this house, we can never agree. Everybody likes to eat different stuff. So the other day when we wanted pizza and everybody else wanted Korean food, I just had to come up with a compromise. And it worked out well. Tomorrow we'll get Korean.
Is that your winter schedule?
Yeah, it's pretty ridiculous.
That is a lot of classes. That's
crazy.
It's
so much. I don't even know what I'm going to do. Yeah.
What time is it?
I don't know.
Oh man, I'm already late to class. I have
but
to go.
No, I thought I was getting a psych notes for you.
I can't. I'm already late. My professor said if I'm late one more time,
No, but you said last week if I missed that you cover me.
It's only like 2 minutes late.
5 minutes.
Oh, fine.
Community college is so much harder than it sounds. I skipped all of my class psychology class last week, and I had to be on Lexi about getting my notes. I don't understand why she would promise to give me notes and then not give them to me. Like, it was
really
shitty.
Well, I thought
really
that was pretty shitty what David did. I mean, I know I told my little girl my notes. You didn't really have to do it in the car. I felt kind of bad. I wanted to tell him no. But I don't know. I just felt, you know, I'm trying to help him out a little bit. I ended up being like too fast. My professor talked to me after class. And I took a lot of heat from that. And I just felt like David really wasn't appreciated.
I was at the club, right, and just last night, and this girl, you know, she was talking to me, right, and I've never had this happen, but she asked if she can buy me a drink. I was like, nice, right, and she actually introduced me to, you know, Snoop Dogg, and I've been looking for someone to help me out with my label, you know, just at least, you know, someone known or whatever, just to record with, and it was real tight.
That's cool. Like, I have this friend, she lives in West Hollywood, right? And she took me to this lounge. It was really sick. Like, all the celebrities were there, we're just chilling. You know, I'm only an English major, so I don't really care about them celebrities. But, like, Angelina Jolie and Brad Pitt came up to me with their African baby. They brought the baby. They brought him over, and they were like, check this out, right? And I was just talking to him, and we're having a nice conversation about, like, politics and what Angelina Jolie is doing in Africa. And I'm like, I got her autograph. She autographed my cigarettes, like, I have them at home, and, like, I have, like, 10 of them. It was sick, and my friend, like, went crazy.
Did they buy you drinks, too?
Yeah, they even bought me drinks! Yes, isn't that crazy? Angelina Jolie and Brad Pitt each bought me a drink. It was ridiculous.
That's so lucky.
I know. And Angelina Jolie has this drink named after her, and then that lounge, I get a special cup.
Ooh, sweet. Pretty nice.
Yeah, I know. So much
better. You
know,
when I was born, my mom, she told me that, actually, like, she was on birth control when she, you know, conceived me. I know TMI or whatever, but it's crazy because when she was giving birth to me, she almost died, and I wasn't supposed to be born, and it was like all these complications with birth and everything, and it kind of shows that, you know, I'm here for a reason, you know.
That's right.
Dude, that reminds me, when my sister was born, like, it was ridiculous. Like, your mom almost died, both my sister and mom almost died. Like, my sister, she was born with, like, her umbilical cord, like, wrapped 6 times around her neck.
Wow.
And my mom, like, she had heart problems at the time, so she was, like, giving birth, and they just both died for, like, a whole minute before the doctors could revive them.
Wow. That's crazy.
I know.
Scary.
I know.
But they're okay now?
They're okay now. Like, my sister's fine. She doesn't have any brain damage. My mom's fine. Like, she got her problems taken care of, and shows, like, they were both, like, definitely here for a reason.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. Pretty awesome, I know, right?
Yeah.
I can believe it myself. Yep.
Good.
I know Jody thinks he's the man of the house and he's telling everyone these stories about how cool he is and how many cool friends he knows. Well, I'm better than him, so I can make up a little couple stories here and there to look better than him.
So, I'm sitting there and David the whole time just wants to be a douchebag, and every time I have a story, I can't even finish my damn story. He's sitting here doing what he's doing. It's pissing me the hell off. Like, I was really thinking about hitting him, but I'm just not going to do that. I'm not going to be, you know, very stereotyped, you know, because I'm pretty sure everybody in this house by now is just thinking, like, oh, he's just going to blow up any fucking minute. You know what? Fuck it.
Yeah, so good. Ignore all of us, you just chill and play your guitar.
So
what do you think? Do you have any suggestions at all?
We could hang out here and have a bash.
Yeah, I mean, that'd be perfect. You could bring your boyfriend, you know, invite, you know, your close friends, but still
sure.
Be, you know, jumping, you know, like a club, but it's just...
It's the last day here.
Yeah.
Just enjoy it here.
Exactly.
Yeah. Alright.
I'm pretty sure Josh, you know, last time.
You got so drunk.
As long as there's a bottle and some music, I'm straight.
Yay. Nice. All right, we can do that.
Awesome. All right,
so we'll just start making phone calls. All
right.
Cool.
I'm already on it.
All right.
I'll call my boyfriend.
All right.
I'll get dressed.
All right. I don't know. It seems like everybody just wanted to do their own thing, you know, for the last day, you know, of the season or whatever. And I feel like, you know, we all got so close, and I don't want everybody to just kind of branch off and do their own thing. So I just thought it would be cool if we all, you know, partied in the house, you know, because, of course, David and Josh, they want to party. And Lexi didn't really want to go out. And basically, you know, all Letitia and, you know, Shelby wanted to do was invite their boyfriends and, you know, some close friends of theirs. And I think I just kind of pulled it off kind of well. You know, I brought everyone together and we all kind of agreed on the same thing. So, yo, this party is going to be great. And you guys won't get to see it, but it's going to be bomb. All right?
So I'm just going to ask, so which style do you identify with more? Then you can just pick one. Okay, ready? Okay, so which conflict style do you identify with more?
Compromise?
Compromise? Can you give us an example?
Me and my friends, we always have like troubles in our class, and then sometimes we help each other in our classes. So then, we had a paper that was due, and then we kind of, we didn't know what to do, so then we each did something, and then we put it together, and then we ended up.
Okay. That's good, thank you.
Hi, my name is James, and according to this conflict paper, I'm more competition. One good example of how I'm trying to define it. Competition is a win or lose approach to conflict that involves high concern for yourself and low concern for others. One good example is I work at a restaurant, and a lot of times where it's busy or I need something done or I need something right away, and I see other coworkers doing their own thing, or they're talking, or they're just wasting time, I'll literally walk in between the two people talking and say, I need this, I need this, I need this right now. And then, sure enough, people just go, like, okay, cool. Right away. Pretty assertive, and for the most part, get what I need or want. So, yeah.
Which ones do you mostly identify with?
Compromise.
Yeah. Because
I don't know. It works best for both.
Okay. That's fine. Okay, try the number. Sorry, I'm like retarded. Okay. So which conflict style do you identify with the most?
A combination?
Can you give us an example of a conflict that you had recently?
Me and my sister. She wants everything her way, so I just like let her do it because I don't want to argue with her a lot. So, and she's younger than me. She's really spoiled.
Alright, that's good. Yeah. Thank you. Yay, thank you very much.
Hi everybody, my name is Letitia Corral, and I'm really excited to be here with the Real World people. It's really great hanging out with all these young children.
What are you? Oh, okay, Letitia, I see how you finally give up.
Okay, ready? Okay.
Jody, I know that Jody...
All right.
You suck.